Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the all-new Forum here in Inglewood, California, serving the greater Los Angeles metropolitan area, where tonight, Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions is proud to bring you an evening of world championship boxing for your entertainment live on HBO. Presented by Tecate, the official beer of boxing, for the WBA and the Ring Magazine Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer, Freddie Roach, wearing orange and officially weighing in at 134.8 pounds. An excellent professional record. 31 victories, including 17 big wins by knockout, only one defeat with two draws. Originally from San Ramigo, Mandaue City, Cebu, Philippines, now living, training, and fighting out of San Diego, California, the challenger, Mercito No Mercy Besa. And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner with his trainer, Ismael Salas. He's wearing camouflage and officially weighed in at 135 pounds. His professional record, outstanding. 43 victories, including 27 wins by knockout. He has three defeats, and he is undefeated for over 5 years. From Barinas, Venezuela, living, training, and fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, the reigning, defending WBA and Ring Lightweight Champion of the World, El Niño de Oro, Jorge Linares.
Coach Freddie, both sets of trunks were above the belt line. I'm going to let them work in here. Guys, I gave you both instruction in the dressing room. I want to remind you, listen and please follow my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Fight hard, fight clean, and good luck.
Okay.
Jack Reese, the third man in the ring. We are ready to go. 12 rounds of lightweight action coming your way. What hit you on is right there on your screen. Taking on Mercito Hesta.
Ready?
Ready? A change of plan. And we are underway. They touch gloves. And we get going from the forearm and Inglewood. Jorge Linares, as you heard Michael Buffer say, hasn't lost in over 5 years. Back in 2012. At back-to-back stoppages. Antonio DeMarco got him. Sergio Yeyo Thompson got him. That was in Mexico. That was 2012. After that, he's changed things up, Doug.
Yeah, he was actually with Freddie Roach for those losses, his back-to-back losses in 2012. And since then, he's been with Ismael Salas, the Cuban trainer. He's got a noted gym in London. So that adds to sort of the international flavor of Jorge Linares' background. Developed as a prize fighter in Japan, from Venezuela. He's made his
pull
name in the
arm,
United
Jorge,
States and in Great Britain. And
let him go, Richard. Stop.
Come here. Still fabulous.
I see him. Pull your arm up. Pull your arm, lad. Let him go and stay off the back of the head.
I like the aggression that I'm seeing from Mercito Hesta, because that's what's always defeated Linares. You don't outbox Linares. Even a boxer is technically sound and skilled as Luke Campbell, Linares just still has that little extra. He's got that flashiness, that speed that judges take note of. If you want to beat Jorge Linares, it takes concussive power, or you got to grind him down. You got to get him into exchanges and bust that face up. That's what Antonio DeMarco did, and that is the task. That's the challenge that Hesta has tonight. He needs to sort of fight out of character a little bit, because he's a talented boxer, but he's not a guy who's used to fighting for 3 minutes of a round, not a guy who's used to applying relentless pressure. Johan is known for starting fast and fading. Hesta, for never getting out of third gear at times.
interesting to see how these two will match up tonight. As Leonard, if Hesta like knocking his head, all right, let's go. That's the walking time. Hesta in the biggest fight of his career, easily the biggest name he's gone up against. When his fight was announced, he's like, really? This one? Hesta tweeted, I appreciate it. I want the opportunity. Let's go. Looking good with his body. Eats it right.
Jumped off the bandwagon with those back-to-back losses in 2012. And they still weren't sold on him when he had to get up from the canvas to stop Kevin Mitchell, hard-nosed contender out of Britain. They weren't sure. They just,
let him go, Marcito.
Won fights, they just still weren't. They weren't sold on him, and then he reminded them of that rematch with Anthony Pereira.
Kevin Mitchell back in 2015 after losing to Yael Thompson. Leonard really just went back to the drawing board and slowly worked himself back. Not some gatekeeper. They were Rodella. They were Rodella fighting everybody. But you got to get that confidence back up there.
It's true. Step by step. Yeah, and I think it's been 12 bouts in a row that has worked.
Marcito Hasta. His dad, actually, a Muay Thai fighter, introduced his son to the sport of boxing in the Philippines. San Diego's now home for him. Solid fighter. His dad actually just sparring with him. One day the sparring partner didn't show up, so his dad, 54 years old, said, let's go.
He looks like it, too. Looks like he can still go rounds. And we should note that Hester didn't have any amateur boxing experience. His first combat sport experience was Muay Thai fights. And then he moved to boxing. So for him to get to this point, we should note he turned pro in the Philippines at age 16. So he learned the jab. But to make it to this point means he's got some natural ability. He has talent. He's got very good, he's got fast hands. He's got power. He's got good footwork. He doesn't always put it all together at the same time.
Sometimes let him go with the right hand.
Flashes of his potential, but that consistency, round after round, we don't always see that from Hester.
Stop, each other, stop, step, box.
True. The same thing has been said about Linares. Although Linares has a more complete fighter and a more polished boxer.
You have Marcito Hesta with the Cleto Reyes, which is more of that puncher glove. He's got the orange.
That's what you want against Jorge Linares, who has those high cheekbones. So, he suffered from cuts around the eyes, swelling around the eyes in the past.
Hesta fought twice in 2017. Humberto Gonzalez, Flaco Gonzalez, which is a good scrap. He went 10 good rounds. And then he stopped Martin Honorio, the Grochas Honorio, which is not an easy task, but Honorio is just game. Stopped him at 8. That was in July. Oh, you hit me, and the most animated I've seen Hesta. I started calling his fights in 2014. He's always very quiet at times. You know, somebody would say Mercito Hesta with a Z instead of an S.
Yeah, sometimes he's not focused in the ring. He seems dialed in. At least he seems emotional about this fight, which is something we didn't see with his first world title shot. That was in December of 2012 against Miguel Vasquez. That quirky, jerky, just pure technician. Bad style matchup for a guy who I don't think was mature enough yet, wasn't ready for that kind of step up in class, but also where Mercito was in his life, he was more focused on bringing the rest of his family to the United States than he was in preparing for his first world title shot.
Back in 2012, you see him, he's more mature now.
Right, that was after a draw that he had with Carlos Molina, maybe called that fight.
He hurt himself in the Carlos Molina fight as a magic strange. Fought one more time against Miguel Mendoza, got the victory. They couldn't do it. I only had one arm. Bill Teeter, pretty much like a baseball player. To go out 2016 and heal himself. He's known, he's on that fringe top 15, right?
Yes, he's a fringe contender.
Stepping up against a fighter of world class.
He doesn't look outclassed so far. I think he has sort of allowed himself to get outworked by the champion.
Two for Manatis in the final seconds of the third. Manatis threw himself for the round. That shot right at the bell.
I hear it.
Manatis coming out right away, the right hander from Venezuela.
In the build-up to this fight, particularly fight week. He's been trying to work on the psyche of Jorge Linares. Trying to put doubts in his head. He's said that Linares is getting long in the tooth.
More than that, he said he's an old man.
At 32. Yeah, 32. He's an old man.
Oh, but he does have 46 fights.
He has a lot of fights. No, and it's not always the age of the fighter. It's how long the fighter has been in the game, how long the fighter has been on the world-class level, how many tough fights the fighter has had. Linares has been around a long time. He has been involved in some brilliant fights. So there is some wear and tear there. Is he an old man? I wouldn't say that. But that's part of Freddie Roach's job, is to hype his fighter up, to give his fighter confidence, and to chip away at the confidence of his fighter's opponent.
Let him go. Let it work out here. Come on, work out. Nope. So don't hit him here. Stop. When you're standing up, don't hit each other.
And Linares gets going.
And he was also going about, and Linares was talking about everybody except for Hesta. He's talking about Mikey Garcia. He's talking about Lomachenko. And you got a fighter in front of you. Negotiations with Mikey Garcia about possibly doing it. Those fights, those negotiations fell apart.
Not because of Linares,
though. It's different. We've all known in the world of boxing.
Mikey Garcia wanted to go in another direction. That's how he wrote it. And that's his prerogative.
Yeah, Mercito Hesta stepped up. Hesta in the orange.
I like that Linares is staying busy, just not waiting for a fellow man to step into the ring with him. But these guys are dangerous. Unheralded challengers like Hesta are dangerous.
Linares fought Luke Campbell September. Here he is back in January in the mix. You have some guys saying, I'm going to take a year off before I fight somebody big. It's, you give him credit for getting in the ring.
Looking very good prior to this.
Time.
anyway for not moving on a Saturday night.
That was 4 a.m.
You're lucky to move that fast at 4 a.m. Oh, Neil Yiannotti is moving against Mercito Hester in the fifth round on schedule for 12.
Again, Roach telling Hester what he needs to hear. He needs to back the RSF. That was a nice right hook by Hester. But he needs to follow up with any hook with the straight left. He needs to be working his jab, and he needs to be coming forward.
Jorge Linares from Venezuela, he left his country at 17 to go to Japan because of the turmoil in Venezuela, and also because the boxing isn't as strong. He left to Japan, and that's where he showed up knowing no Japanese, knowing nobody else said he would take a chance on
box.
He learned the language, learned the food, learned the culture. He's now all over advertising. He's on billboards. You can see him everywhere. He pays a lot of respect to taking promotions.
He did a great job. He took to the culture, too. That helped, in fact, that he liked the culture. That's a big difference, too. He liked, you know, he's a Tokyo guy.
Let him go.
From 2002 to 2005, his heights were in Japan. He knows the Far East. He actually spent 3 weeks for his camp in Tokyo, then he went back to Las Vegas, his home base.
Yeah, it's like a pre-camp in Tokyo where they do a lot of running, a lot of conditioning, a lot of aerobic type stuff. Then he gets to Vegas and the sparring is there waiting for him.
Actually sparred with Manny Robles Jr., the son of the trainer Manny Robles.
That's good work.
Talking to Manny Jr., like, what was the light? He's like, it's intense when you're in there because he doesn't take any seconds off when he's sparring. He's a great guy out of it. Manny was supposed to be there for one day, like what he left.
He's coming out of workout.
So he was staying here for a week. Manny's like, I didn't bring that gear for a week because I hear you got who's back for the stop. One, two, by the shot. Hester puts his hands up, let's go. As the action picks up here in the fifth round.
This is the fifth round. It looks like Linares has gotten into his rhythm with rounds 3 and 4. So this prize fight heats up. I still feel like Hester needs to be doing a little bit more. He's falling back into that habit of kind of looking more like a sparring partner than somebody who's in there trying to win a world title.
Consistency, offensively speaking, that has really helped him out.
can let his hands go more, I think he would have more victories by knockout.
Don't throw a punch off like that.
Because he smiles after every flush shot. Whenever he gets hit, that's when he smiles. So you don't want to see him smile.
Stop. Please, both of you guys. Box.
Seventh round is good for 12.
Jorge, pull you, that's it.
Yeah, that's not bad, but I don't think one punch is going to be good, especially if you're not.
for having that much power.
I think he has to be hit. I think he has enough power to hurt Linares, but he's got to set that power up and catch him with the shot he doesn't see, or he needs to try to overwhelm him with volume. He's got to put those shots together. Maybe Linares slips one punch, blocks another, and that third shot of the three-punch combination lands.
We haven't seen a three-punch combination test in a while. Oh, no, we had a little bit.
And it's hard because Linares moves very well about the ring. So, Hester, someone needs to have his feet set when he's going to land more than a two-punch combination.
Let him go, Horry. Pull your arm out.
With those bright orange shoes, you can tell when he's setting. Definitely not sitting down on any kind of punches. It's funny how the boxing world works. You lose a fight, everybody jumps off your bandwagon. You lose back to back, you get stopped. Like Linares did, and forget you out of sight, out of mind. You got to climb your way back in. And even in 2016, when he went to England to fight Anthony Crowley, how many people were even talking about Linares having a chance in that fight? Now, saying he gets by Hester, there's Garcia out there, the Lomachenko's out there.
And he's looking good. This isn't easy work.
No.
So you do see the cut on on the outside of his right eye. It's probably from the clash of heads.
No, I'm not saying this is easy at all, but you see the level. Running out of the world champion fighter.
Yeah, excellent jab. Very good at setting up his right hand. He uses his left. Sometimes he paws with the jab like that. He sets up a straight right. Sometimes he uses a hook to distract Hester, and then he sneaks a straight right in.
Got a cut.
And mixes the straight rights to the body and then back up to the head. He's creative in there. Hester, it looks like he's out of ideas.
He said, this is where you got to be mentally strong. You have the power. We have this fight won, but I want you to win impressionably. Put on a show and do that by putting your combinations together.
And Salas is saying that because he does know that typically this is the point where the Linares begins to fade.
And look at how he comes out. Be mentally strong because you know you have a fighter who, the knock on the right around these times, when he lets a guy come back into a fight.
See, Hester is trying to land that right hook in between the volleys from Linares. So Hester kind of likes it when Linares is letting three and four punch combinations with both hands, because he's like, well, maybe I can sneak one in between these shots. Thing is,
pull your arm out, Jorge. Pull your arm out.
This, what he sees is counter punch opportunities. And in boxing, you have to create your opportunities. Face is a mess after a fight where he completely dominated.
Maybe a sixth time he's been caught, he has to try to bring some pressure. They get all the way down to the line. What a showmanship from both of them. Crowd reacting, they're liking it. Brutal show, huh?
Let him go.
Pull your arm out. Pull your, here you go.
Referee Jack Reese is allowing the fighters to work it out when they get tied up on the inside. I like that.
Veteran guys, reverse up. Trying to tie him up on purpose. Work your way out of it. Final seconds of the ninth round. Headed to the championship round between Linares.
High punch, stop.
Patient from the corner of Linares. Salas the key right. He did a great job with his fighters. Trainer.
Didn't have a bad ninth round. He got some moments there. Just hasn't been able to rock or wobble. Linares. I'm sure the game plan for Freddie Roach was for us to put more backhand on Linares. To cause some stress.
This could be the defending champion, right? But also to make it a very physical fight where, you know, Linares is eating more than just a few punches and a shoulder that produces a cut by the right eye. I'm sure Roach was hoping to see many abrasions on the face of Linares by this point in the fight. You see those socks, we're not sure that's on the compression socks on the legs of Jorge Linares. Now, let's look at the tag. They're worn by runners and triathletes.
Cyclists,
it's to keep the calves and have the blood flow going. And Linares is one of the last couple of fights. Asked him, like, what is wrong? I started running with them, love them, and it just keeps my legs fresh later on in the round.
So the commission's cool with it, so why not?
They are super tight. I would think it's hard to get on. His conditioning looks good.
Mark, Linares got a little cut from punches on his nose.
Punches on the nose.
Watch the backhands, fellas.
Some work done himself, but he's just not able to do it. I don't know what it is with him. I mean, you have to give Linares credit. Linares is not going to just stand there and let you wear the way on him, but it's still that pattern that we've seen from Hester's previous bouts against lesser competition, where there's these just periods of the round where he's not doing anything. I mean, he's moving. The auto body's moving. He's moving the hands. Now he's not punching.
He's not bringing it. Now we're done with 10. It ain't the work. He's not doing this. You go back there, you'll see some of the who's who or rock stars are performing this at the floor. So the Eagles here. Now take it easy, baby. Refurbished, beautiful location for boxing.
Can you turn around? Pull your hands out, both of you.
In the 11th round. Linares with the red. Hester in the southpaw position, but he's not really a southpaw. His dad, when he started training him, said, you're going to fight as a southpaw. He's naturally right-handed. His dad wanted Hester to use his dominant hand as his lead hand. So a lot of the Filipino fighters have done.
Yeah, most of them. Most of the Filipino standouts that we see in the U.S. are converted southpaws.
And the younger ones will say, oh, I saw Manny Pacquiao fighting that way. I did it too.
Sure, they went to.
That's his father converted their gym, their garage, into a boxing gym. And that's how he started training. But that was back with Muay Thai.
Stop, both of you, stop. Step away from each other.
And
be loud.
Hester is his father.
Right, and a former Muay Thai boxer.
I think he's still fighting because he fought 2 years ago. And he's still
just in his 50s.
He's in his 50s. He's 54 and he still spars, dude.
Respect.
And he has the same tattoo as the same badge, the tribal one over his chest. Right now he's won watching the sun. Hey, tough one against $100, and the Niners put on a nice clinic.
Hesta's father did a good job with him. Obviously, Hesta has received good work at the Wild Card Boxing Club. He's receiving good advice, obviously, from Hall of Fame trainer and Phil Roach, but it just looks like Linares hasn't figured out yet.
Pull your arm out, Jorge. Jorge, pull it out.
Linares is on that world championship level. Hesta is not there.
And style-wise, it's like Hesta doesn't have anything special for him. That's a well. He does it. He occasionally lands. If you're a Hesta fan, he gives you hope. Put some money on Hesta. Put some money on the underdog. He gives you hope in spots. Doesn't put it together enough to heap real damage.
Hesta is promoted by Bull and the Boy. Interesting to see how they move in this group, because they have a lot of 135ers that are not up and coming. It has to be the B-side against one of those guys. He brought the answer to the United. He learned something about himself. He learned that there's
stop. Let him kill the goat. Stop at the bell.
As the United continues to rise.
Good luck, fellas.
Well, then final round. Jorge Linares, Mercito Hesta, the former number one. You heard Fred Roach telling his fighter in orange, give me the best 3 minutes of your life.
And that Hesta needs to. He's got 3 minutes to make something happen. If not, I think he becomes a stepping stone opponent.
See him in May. Let's just say Canelo's gonna fight in May. Come on, we all know.
No, no.
Hey, nothing official, but Canelo fights in May in September, people. And the Niners was cut on that right eyebrow, so see how that cut heals. About to slip again.
Here. Three gloves.
Told him, boy, Jorge Linares. Feeling himself in that ring. Michelle with
him. Let him go.
Hesta trying to come out. He's doing his corner, telling him to get the best. Just third gear, guys. We haven't seen it before. We don't have a feeling. Cruising.
He does not need to be in cruise control. He needs to be full throttle.
Looks like the jockey at Santa Anita.
Ooh,
trying to whip the horse.
That wasn't bad.
You're trying to whip that horse and get yourself across the line, but your horse is running the show. He doesn't want to go win that race.
Well, both guys have proven to be able to take the best power shots from each other.
But
in that situation, you either need to outbox your opponent or outwork your opponent. Hesta's not going to outbox the Niners.
Would like him to have. From the opening bell to the final bell, Jorge Linares has looked good. Did not fade at last. They retained himself, controlled his fight. Very back in the United States, but consistently strong. Yes, he did. A good show for Jorge Linares against Mercito Hesta as Linares is going to come to the corner.
And gentlemen, after 12 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Esther Lopez and Max LaLuca both have it. 118 to 110. Eddie Hernandez Sr. scores at 117 to 111. All three to the winner by unanimous decision. And still, WBA Ring Magazine, lightweight champion of the world, El Niño de Oro, Jorge.
the fight. Control the guard.